let's start by seeing if we can create one of these circles. Well, let's start with two, why not? And I'll put a multiple of two next to it, let's put six, and then think about what could go next. Well, if I put a multiple of six here, then it's also going to be a multiple of two. And that means that it needs to be a neighbor of two, so we could just stop here, and we know that three is happy. Okay. But what if I didn't want to stop there? If I didn't want to stop there, I can have two and six. And we've just seen I can't put a multiple of six there because then it would be a multiple of two as well. So we'll put a factor of six. And we start to see a pattern emerging. If I just add in this notation here to show that two is a factor of six and three is a factor of six, as we just discussed, we can't have two arrows going in the same direction because then two would be a factor of this one here. So we've seen that this pattern is needed where the arrows showing which number goes into another have to alternate. And that's only going to be possible if we've got an even number of integers around the circle. See what happens if we try and do it with an odd number. When we get to the last remaining gap, it doesn't matter which way we put the arrow, we're going to end up with three in a row where one goes into the next and that one goes into the next, and that's not allowed. So it's only going to be possible to find happy numbers if it's three or they're even. We know that three is. Is it possible that all even numbers are happy? So can we find some kind of construction that means we can show that any even number is happy? Well, if we take distinct primes and put them in every other position, P, Q, W a prime, and then we multiply those two primes together to fill in the gaps so that this one is the product of its two neighbors. And we do this all the way round. This seems to work. Because they're different primes, we're not going to have any factors or multiples across the circle, but we've ensured that it is a factor or multiple when they're neighboring. It seems like we're done, except this doesn't work when we've got four. Because in the case where we have got four spaces, we would have P and Q and PQ, but the one joining them would also be PQ, and we can't double up again. So we've done three, we've done every other even number, but not four. So let's just see if we can find a solution for four. And it happens that this works. We can do 2 and 12, 3 and 18. And that shows that 4 is also a happy number. So in terms of finding the ones that we needed, we've shown 3 and all of the even numbers. So that's 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12.